everyone, we're going to deconstruct. I'm going to deconstruct today my very first obsession, which I shall prove to you at the end of this deconstruction that it was my very first. However, let's just first cleanse the palate by listening to her. Susan Johnson, The Most Happy Fella. This voice sort of set the template for voices I'm obsessed with. It's in the mask, very much so. Fast, delicious vibrato. Plus, like, there's a warmth to it. Like, all I want to do is become her best friend. Okay, this is Ooh My Feet, the very first song from Most Happy Fella. Listen as she does the dip line. She goes, bet your life a waitress earns her pay. And spin vibrato, and she bites into the diphthong. Here we go.
Ooh, my feet, my poor, poor feet. Bet you your life a waitress earns her pay.
Do you hear that? Pay. The delicious bitten diphthong.
Bet you your life a waitress earns her pay. I've been on my feet, my poor, poor
Violet.
Feet. All day long.
And what I love is also that she puts vibrato in the word special. It's not even that long of a word, but she literally gets vibrato. She goes, doing my blue plate special. Listen.
Doing my blue plate special.
Do you hear that? She spins it.
Special.
Oh, I love it. Okay, that's part one. I love all of Most Happy Fella. I'm going to play one number from Act Two. This is where the sister of Tony, played by this headachy opera singer, just cut on the bad acting and the bad vocal placement. But anyway, she's obsessed with Tony, this old man who's married this younger woman, and she's trying to gossip with Susan Johnson. And it's a brilliant song by Frank Lester because the gossiping that Marie is doing into Susan Johnson's ear, her gossiping voice becomes a saxophone. So she's like, chitter-chatter, chitter-chatter, and finally her chitter-chatter is taken over by the saxophone and Susan Johnson starts dishing Marie to the audience. Okay, listen to it and check out the bad acting from the sister.
Oh, Cleo! I gotta talk to you. I know I can talk to you.
A voice.
You're her friend and he's my brother. You understand we can talk to one another.
The other thing I love is that Susan Johnson has sort of a 50s accent. I don't quite know what it is. You know, in the 40s, everyone talked like this. But in the 50s, it's like a flattening of the vowel. She goes, I understand, stand, stand. It's almost an aw. I understand. I'm obsessed with the 50s accent of Susan Johnson. It comes up later. Stand.
My brother, you understand we can talk to one another. You understand. When they get married, little by little, from the difference in their ages comes the trouble.
Listen to the chitter chatter.
All the trouble.
Becomes a saxophone.
A million kinds of trouble.
Is that amazing?
I don't like this dame. No, I don't like her one bit. But since I'm company right now, into her eye I can't.
More chitter chatter coming up.
And it's a dirty trick on both of them. When little by little, from the difference in their ages, comes the trouble. All the trouble. A million kinds of trouble.
Obsessed with
that. I don't like this day.
Okay, and I love that Susan Johnson. She goes, I'm getting pains in my head, but since I'm company right now, I guess I can't suggest her dropping. And she doesn't say dead, but she does do the D. I guess I can't suggest her dropping. I'm obsessed with the D. Listen.
I'm getting pains in my head. But since I'm company right now, I guess I can't suggest her dropping.
Do you understand?
Then there's this, I'm obsessed with the song Big D, which is like the big classic, well, one of the big classic songs from the show. I love Shorty Long. He plays Herman, the sidekick. But I only have like half of this on my, my Walkman, old school, on my cassette, because the horrible chorus comes in halfway through, an awful chord that doesn't go with the song, and it just It's just a horrible interruption to a delicious song. Okay, listen to this for a second.
Evening, ma'am.
Okay, this song's amazing.
And that spells Dallas. I mean it with no malice, but the rest of Texas looks a mess when you're from Big D. My, oh yes. And it's Big D, little A, double L-A. Big D, little A, double L-A. Big D, little A, double L-A.
Shut up! You just ruined an amazing song. Shut up! Okay, now, here's one of the songs at the end of the show. It's not even a song. You know, most of people, it's just, it's so ahead of its time. It's like the first really sung through musical. So there are all these scenes that are totally sung through. So this is the final scene where the sister is trying to prevent, Marie is trying to prevent Tony from winding up with his young wife. And she's like, nobody's ever going to love you like I love you. It's a total codependent, sick, sort of Oedipus, but it's not the mother and the son. It's the sister and the brother. It's sick. And Cleo is like, you know, he's got your number, sister. And she's sassing Marie. And I'm just obsessed with his voice. His. It's her voice. Susan Johnson. So hold on, let me find it. Now listen, she has that 50s accent because you don't stand a chance, chance, instead of chance, or Long Island style, chance. Okay, listen. By the way, the other thing I want to hear one more time, listen to her when she comes on the word he's. He's all you've got. It's deliciously in the mask. Susan Johnson, I love thou. Instead of the he's. I love that. Okay. And now, finally, the proof that I've been obsessed with Ooh My Feet all my life, Susan Johnson, Must Happy Fella. First of all, it was my audition song when I was 12 years old. Why don't we hear me singing it? I'm playing the piano. And by the way, remember, I'm from Long Island. So a la chance, I literally go, ooh, my feet, my poor, poor feet, because I'm from Long Island. Here we go.
Ooh, my feet. This is me. My poor, poor feet. Back to your life, a waiter and despair.
Poor, poor.
I've been on my feet, my poor, poor feet, all day long today.
Okay, cut. And just so you're thinking, 12 years old, that's not his whole life. Oh, really? Here's me, literally as a toddler. It was before my third birthday, so obviously I've been listening to this at least since I was 2, because I literally knew the lyrics before I turned 3 years old. This is literally me as a toddler singing it. It's not like a marked up tape. It's literally me. Wait, the crack is amazing on On. Hold on. Hold on.
It's a fake, no fake, a poor, poor fake, all day, all day.
Anybody? Can you see? That's what it looked like when I was singing. Okay, and on that note, cut.